Welcome back to a new episode. Today we are trying to button up all the little stuff left on light work here. Now the idea is that we should be able to hopefully start and drive the truck for the first time today. Not very far, because there's a bunch of other little stuff we gotta do, but we're trying to get it running and driving. Leon's already done a whole bunch of little stuff, so I'm going to include that right now.
Today we're going to put on this Y-bridge that my buddy sent me. I already test fitted it. It fits good. I had to go get a seal for this and some bolts. I already got those picked up. I don't know if I mentioned it, but this engine is a whole lot more compact than the newer one, and it's kind of a pain in the butt to get everything in there. I think I'm gonna pressure wash everything when I get all done because it is gross. Gotten the front ones in, the easy ones done. So time to get the back ones in nice and loose and then tighten them all down. Oh, that was quick. Yes. Ha! Now I gotta do the hardest one. That one. I was wondering if this bolt could be any closer. No, not without taking it out. I got this 10 millimeter and trying. Yeah, I think it started, maybe. Every time I think though, it kind of falls out. Finally in, everything is tightened down. What a pain in the butt. We're about to put on the front piece here, and I went ahead and just replaced these fuel lines. These little guys were all cracked up, and trying to make this the most reliable I can so we don't get stuck on the side of the road, because I'm not trying to do that. It's too dang hot here. We're all bolted in, ready to go. All right, I've got the hose that goes down to the pump. This gotta go here, that goes down there. Gotta shove this guy here, and then I guess I gotta bend this up just a tad so that fits. Gotta run and go get a new one of these. I ripped it when I took it off. Took an old dash 10 and I stuck it in the side of the transmission and it threaded in all nice. I'm gonna go ahead and test out this new fitting I bought. Ooh, it's got a nice little seal. That's cool. Good, good. I like it. Got all the new fuel lines and everything put on. I still got to get this coolant line done and block this off because that used to go to the EGR. We're not going to use that no more. We're going to have to cut this pipe down, make it fit here. And then, of course, the old intake that I made doesn't fit. So this one's just a little bit off still, but I got a whole lot more room to work with. Actually, both sides, a ton less wiring. This one we're gonna have to shorten probably 6 inches, and then I'll show you the problem we're having with the turbo mouthpiece. I mean, basically, if I really wanted to, I could probably modify it. I've already banged it in for the old Y-bridge I made, so it doesn't look that great, and I'm really not trying to, I don't know. We'll see. Kind of looks like hell. I'll see how much a new one is. If it's too much, we'll just go ahead and make one. I think I mentioned before that the math is actually different. I went ahead and bought this. I don't know if I'm going to be able to use it. If I get a new piece, it might come with it on it. I don't even know if I need to run the math on this, but I'm gonna put it on just in case. Here's the old air temp sensor, and I'm thinking I want to take it out and put it in one of the pipes, but I'm not sure which one yet. I might put it down inside the actual intake pipe, so there's no chance that it can be a boost leak, but I guess we'll see once we get everything else. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have some exciting news. Just got back from the drive shaft place. Ooh-wee. This thing costs more than, shoot, this thing costs double of what I usually pay for an LS. Well, as everybody knows, when there's good news, there's always a little bit of bad news. That fits, but these don't. Too big. This guy all tightened up. Now, all I gotta do is go back and get the right size bolts and straps. Friday, my only goal was to get the drive shaft in, which did not happen. I ran around town trying to get some of the bolts and straps, the hardware kit to put it on. Finally, after the third attempt, I went to Napa. They had it. I started putting them in. I got about halfway with one of the bolts. Snapped off right in the yoke. So had to go get another yoke. Took a little time off this weekend. Me and my buddy Mike, we went over to Kentucky. Ended up picking up this guy. I've been needing a new daily because the diesel is terrible on fuel. And it's manual and a LS. Kind of figured while I was up that way, you know, raid every gas station on the way back. Ended up getting this yoke, which actually looks way worse than the one that was on it. So gotta clean that up. I'm gonna actually just go ahead and tap the threads. This way I don't have no problems. Clean them up and
Gotta go get another kit.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and clean this thing up a little bit. And I'm gonna tap the holes, paint it, throw it on, and hopefully we can get the drive shaft in.
I've got the drive shaft off. Now we're gonna try to get this yoke off.
It's either gonna be really easy or really hard, because I tried two of them at the junkyard. One came off, one didn't.
Well, that's acting a whole lot like the one that didn't. Well, last time I seen a Snap-on guy was a little bit ago. I had to rebuild this, and this is the first time I really used it, and I just broke it again without trying. So, no sense in being nice to it. Might as well give it hell.
Take that, you bitch.
Well, it's working. That's a shame I went through all the work to make this thing look nice. That's all right. This one doesn't look as nice, but that's okay.
Uh-huh. Oh, there it is.
That worked out pretty good. It's the first time something so simple has taken me so long. So I drilled and tapped this real quick for the 3/8 line that goes to the turbo. This is for the coolant line. And this will be put on for the last time, hopefully. Well, everything's all tightened down. Looking like we have just enough room to get the line on. Okay, so everything's on. And looks like we have just enough room to get the line on. I put it more to the side so that it'd be out of the way of all this. And it looks pretty good. There's only a couple more lines left to put on. I got this little 90 I have to go buy a piece. And well, that might be it. That might be the last little tiny line that I have to redo. Yeah, if I was a little more gentle, I probably could reuse this one. But I figured, what the heck, might as well just go ahead and replace everything that's in that area because I don't want to redo it later. It would only break down in Florida, you know, like 100 degrees or something. And yeah, nah, I'm not dealing with that.
Advance is so lovely. I go in there and I'm like, hey,
I need some hose this size, you know, for the 90, the return. And the guy's like, oh, I can't, you know, I can't sell you this. It's not a foot.
And he ain't got no more. Well, then give it to me.
You're not gonna let me have this little piece because it's not a foot. Get out of here. Anyways, I made him feel good. So I bought a whole 2 feet of this, which is 3 times the price anyways, because I needed, they didn't have anything but fuel injection line, which is apparently more than AN line now. And I gotta go from there to there. That's it. I think it probably cost me more than just going to a different store and buying it normal.
All right, we got our last coolant line on for the turbo, and I think that's pretty much it for all the lines behind the down there in the valley and everything.
This one's a little squished. I don't like it, but it's just a coolant line for the turbo, so let's fingers crossed. Hopefully it's good. While I'm here up top, figured might as well go ahead and start making the intercooler pipes again. See how they look. Kind of sad because the other ones look pretty good. Round two.
So I cut the end off of this one in there, and I'm gonna flop it around this way and then cut it here and see how it matches up. Hopefully it's good. Hopefully flop things around again, and I put this back the way it was, and I think I might like that better. It's a little tighter. It gives me a whole lot more room over here on the fender well if I want to put something. I marked it a little bit short. I'm gonna cut it here and test fit it.
Well, it worked out pretty good first try, so that works. A little bit close here, but that's okay. I can still get the plug, and it kind of hides some of the wiring, which is nice. Oh yeah, plenty of room. I can get that on and off. Still gotta do the MAF and the map sensor. So I can go ahead and hide the map sensor probably on the back side. I think that'll look okay. I'll find a good spot and we'll go from there.
Put it right here. Fits the pipe pretty good. The plug will come in from the back side, so it won't look too terrible. Hopefully I can clean this up, get most of that nasty oil off of it.
Just tacked up, looking so fresh and so clean. I've been soaking this piece in some acetone, and I'm gonna try to go ahead, drill a hole and tack it on. I also brushed it with the wire brush, and we'll see. It should weld pretty good. Got it where it fits the best. What I'm gonna do is just mark it with a screwdriver, and then I'll go ahead and drill the hole. Then I can clean it all up and tack it on. I decided just to cut it a little short
and it was a good choice because by the time it went in, now it's lined up decent. I only cut off about a little less than half an inch.
Couple clamps on that coupler right there.
Everything else is tightened down, ready to go.
Not sure I'm a fan of how this looks, but maybe something like that will work for now till I get the intake in.
Other than the bottom being a little bit milky on the filter, everything else looks pretty good, which is nice. We're gonna go ahead and drop the filter. We're gonna let that drain for a little bit, get everything out, and reinstall the new filter and pan.
I'm gonna go ahead, get these all in, and zip them down.
Looks awesome, and fits good. Wasn't too bad putting it on. A bad thing is the transmission crossmember was the lowest point of the truck, and the pan is quite a bit lower than that, and I really hope it doesn't drag.
It's starting to look pretty professional. Oh, that's better.
Well, camber died, but it kept working. Anyways, I did the race plug in the back of the rail. And if you're wondering how hard it was, basically took the two bolts out of the glow plug module and then three bolts out of the bracket, and I got to it right from the back. It would have been easy doing it in the regular truck because you could just do it from the outside. I could have done it from the outside, but it said to torque it down to 72 to 74 foot-pounds. And it was just easier getting my torque wrench in here on the extension. All installed, wasn't too bad. I was gonna make a whole video of doing that by itself, but I decided it was so fast that I should just knock it out and get it done. So I bought this transmission dipstick for a Turbo 400, and I ended up selling the truck, so I'm gonna use it for this instead. The actual dipstick is a little bit off, but I know when it's about halfway up the stick, that's where it's supposed to be when the transmission is hot. So we'll just go off that. It's not like you check it all the time if it's not leaking. I'm going to fill it up, let it get warm, check it. If it's good, then it should be good for a while. If I see any drips or any leaks, then I'll check it more often.
Why would they be under there?
I don't know. Why would they be anywhere other than there they are, next to the cooler.
Gotcha.
Hey, so we went to the store, Andrew's warehouse, and we got these four matching, I supplied the bolts, he had the nuts.
Yeah, boy.
These are LS head bolts.
Yep.
So.
Perfect for mounting coolers.
So maybe it'll be reliable for once.
Oh, LS guy working on Duramax stuff.
It's not the Duramax's fault, I don't know what I'm doing. So we're going to have to pull the bench seat out. And then I'll mark it at the bottom, and we'll cut the holes.
Sounds good.
Cut the holes. We'll drill the holes.
Can you lay that cooler inside?
Put the cooler under the seat, drill a hole.
There you go.
Yeah.
More airflow.
Blow it out the bottom.
Basically, it's like old school cooled seats.
Except for the inside of the cab's probably going to be hotter than outside, because we don't have AC yet.
There's that. So currently we're working on this cooler. Now, as you can see, it's got 1, 2, 3 and then 1, 2, 3 mounting tabs on both sides. We're trying to tuck it up underneath the truck as much as possible, but we want to allow for a bunch of airflow. So currently Leon's making some spacers that will stand this off, obviously underneath. Then we got to remove the bench seat that's inside and make new mounting points so that we can mount this up underneath there. It's literally as tight as it could be. Yep, that was those other tools you hit last time. Yep. So as long as we were super duper close, we'll be good.
Should be.
Can't see it, but we just got all the torque converter bolts in. What a pain in the butt. So now we got to get the starter in, and apparently we need to make a wire for the starter. Well, the starter's in. now we are working on wiring. So the idea is that we're going to get one side in and then run it over to the fuse box and then continue from there. This isn't very fun to watch, so we're just going to tune back in when it's all in. So Leon's got all the power wires coming to this terminal. They come up from underneath. He's currently wiring up the batteries. There's two of them.
I was going to wire them up from the next door, but I don't know if we have enough.
Right. Quite a bit. So then we feed power over here and then out of the fuse block, and we've got the alternator wire coming back. The ECU is mounted temporarily. Let's go check in on Mr. Leon.
It's a mess.
I'm getting pretty excited though. It's close.
I'm not. I'm tired. Just want a nap. That's what I want.
Permanently?
Yes. If this doesn't work, then yes. Okay.
Oh, no. Just a little excess.
Yeah. This one is the negative. I don't even remember how these things get to. It's been a while. I don't remember if it goes to this one or that one.
All right, we'll check back in a minute.
Yep.
Fuel pump's on, so that's something. Batteries are wired. We heard a bunch of relays clicking.
I figured I'd let it run for a second to get all the fuel.
Yeah.
And also to look and see and make sure that
we're not leaking.
I don't see any leaks. All right, well, I guess we could try to start it.
It's in park still?
Could be. Looking like it. Are you ready?
I guess so.
It's probably going to take a second because all the lines are empty.
Right.
Right in my face.
Let's go!
And I'm back for the first try.
Well, that's wonderful.
That's not bad. I like it.
It sounds different than the other one.
Better. It's the same. Yeah, the only intercooler pipe I left loose was this one, so that if we had to
shut it off,
get it out of the way.
So. Oh. I was thinking of that runaway diesel thing.
Oh, no, no.
My bad.
That's... Ha!
Yeah.
Okay.
Now what?
We gotta put transmission fluid in it.
Are we going to do that here, or are we going to do that...
Huh?
We're going to do that up here? Or are we going to do that? I don't know why I'm so nervous about it leaking hundreds of dollars of goo all over the concrete.
Well, if I'm going to destroy anything, might as well destroy the slab. You're like, you piece of...
The old lifeblood of the transmission.
So the this dipstick wasn't long enough either.
Is it always going to be in the...
I guess we're going to measure, or we're going to check from the inside, but like I said, it's not something that you're going to check on a daily basis, you know what I mean? Once it's full, as long as you haven't got leaks.
So we're going to fire this thing back up. We added a bunch of fluid to the transmission. We're going to let it get hot, and then check the fluid level to make sure that we haven't overfilled or underfilled it. You want me to do the bad explanation, or you want to do it?
Go ahead. I'll let you do it.
So, Leon just started it up, and we were letting the trans warm up, and he moved it forward, and then went to move it backwards, and there was no reverse.
No anything, no gears. It started flashing, and it said, service four-wheel drive. So the ECU doesn't see the four-wheel drive. So now we gotta get a tune. Fun.
Yep.
Back to this. No. At least this one should be easy to get tuned. So.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I guess that's it for this episode.
It works.
It does work. So stay tuned. There's a lot more to go with this project, but this was a major milestone. I hope you guys are excited. All right, we'll see you on the next episode. Subscribe to Rustahaulic if you haven't. Stay tuned.